Dear viewers, right decisions on the right time give you an advantage over the others. I am your host Muhammad Asif Jajja and you are watching my YouTube channel ETV786. Through this channel, we are learning the basic concepts of accounting. And this is lesson 6 on the basic concepts of accounting and title is Sales Journal. So we will learn today that what is the sales journal. The sales journal or sales book or sales day book is a special journal that is used to record all credit sales. Every transaction that is entered in sales journal results in a debit to account receivable and a credit to sales account. All cash sales are recorded in another special journal known as cash receipts journal. Only the goods or merchandise or stock or inventory business normally deals in are recorded in sales journal. The sales of assets such as old plant, machinery, equipment and newspaper etc. are not recorded in the sales journal. These transactions are entered in general journal. Sale invoice. When seller or supplier sells goods, merchandise, inventory or stock on credit, he prepares an invoice known as sale invoice. This invoice is sent to the customer along with the merchandise. Seller also prepares a duplicate copy of sales invoice. This duplicate copy is kept by the seller with him because the entry in the sales journal is made on the basis of this sale invoice. The example of the sale invoice . It must include an invoice number, date of the invoice, due date, and terms of the sales. It obviously includes the title, address, and contact information of the vendor who is making this sale invoice, and the identity of customer, his address and contact information. The column usually included in the sales invoice are quantity, description, rate, amount, total and remarks. Always remember that sale invoice and purchase invoice are two different names of the same document. It is always prepared by the seller and is called sales invoice in the record of the seller and purchase invoice in the record of the buyer. The seller uses it to record a sales transaction in the sales journal and the buyer uses it to record a purchase transaction in the purchase journal. Here is a sales journal for your consideration. It includes a page number of the book, column of date, column of account debited, column of invoice number, post reference, account receivable debit and sales credit, and a column of cost of goods sold debit and inventory credit. Here is the explanation of columns. The date column. This column is used to record the date of which the sale is made. Normally, it is the same date as written on the invoice. Account debited. This column is used to enter the name of customers whose individual account are maintained in account receivable subsidiary ledgers. Invoice number. The sale invoice number is written in this column. Post reference. The entries in sales journal are posted on daily basis to relevant accounts in account receivable subsidiary ledgers. The post reference is used to enter account number on individual accounts in the account receivable subsidiary ledgers in which the entries are posted. Account receivable and sales. In this column, the net amount receivable from customer is written in the general ledger. The account receivable account is debited and sales account is credited by the total of this column. Cost of goods sold and inventory. In this column, the cost price of the merchandise sold is entered in general ledger. The cost of goods sold account is debited and inventory account is credited by the total of this column. Posting entries from sales journal to subsidiary ledgers and general ledgers. The entries in sales journal must be posted from sales journal to individual accounts in account receivable subsidiary ledgers and general ledgers. The posting procedure is briefly explained below. Number 1. Posting to account receivable subsidiary ledgers. At the end of each day or immediately after the transaction has been performed, the individual entries are debited to appropriate accounts in account receivable subsidiary ledgers. Posting to general ledgers. At the end of each month or another appropriate period, the column totals of sales journal are posted to relevant general ledger accounts as follows. Number 1. The total of accounts receivable and sales column is debited to account receivable account and credited to sales account in the general ledger. The total of cost of goods sold and inventory column is debited to cost of goods sold account and credited to the inventory account in the general ledger. Number 3. To indicate that the posting has been made to general ledger accounts, the account number of general ledger account are written in parentheses below the total of the relevant columns of sales journal. This is an example of sales journal. This is the page number 5 of the sales journal that includes the column of date of the transaction, account debited, invoice number, post reference, account receivable debit and sales credit, cost of goods sold debit and inventory credit. Sales journal with sale tax payable. The sales journal given above shows that the seller is collecting a sale tax at the rate 10% on all goods sold to customers. The posting of this sales journal will be similar to the posting explained in the above example. A sales tax payable account would be opened in the general ledger and the total of sales tax payable column of sales journal would be credited to that account at the end of each month or another appropriate period. So this is the example of sales journal including the sale tax payable. So one column will be added in the sales journal and that will be sale tax payable. So account receivable from the individual's account debited will include the total sale price and sale tax payable. So total amount will be debited to account receivable will be sale plus sale tax payable. Note, in normal courses of business, when customers receive damaged, defective, low quality or otherwise undesirable goods, they may return them to the seller or may have the option to retain them at a reduced price. Sales returns occur when a customer does not accept such goods and return them to the seller for a full refund or credit, and sales allowance occurs when the customer chooses to accept them but at a reduced price. In a company's general ledger, the sales return and the sales allowance are recorded in a single account known as sales return and allowances account. Thank you for watching my channel ETV786, and thanks for watching the video and your feedback, which is very encouraging. Please like, share the videos and subscribe the channel more and more so that these videos can reach to the people really need this information. Bye bye.